So good evening students, today I am going to explain the Lagrange's theorem. Lagrange's theorem is basically related with the group and its subgroup. So in this theorem, let us see the statement.
The order of each subgroup of a finite group is a division of the order of the group. Means the order of each subgroup of a finite group is a divisor of the order of the group. So now let us see the proof of this theorem. Let H be a subgroup of order M of a finite group of order n. Let H be a subgroup of order n of a finite group G. Finite group G of order n. That is to say, order of H equals to m and order of G equals to n, and m is less than n. Now, in order to prove this theorem, we use two parts. We normally follow two parts. So in order to prove the first part, we show that each coset, that is AH, has or consists m distinct elements. So each coset consists m distinct elements. So H can be written as, now this is H1, H2, H3 and so on up to Hm, and the left cosets can be written as AH1, AH2, AH3 and so on up to AHn, where A belongs to G. So this A belongs to G, and these are the left cosets and these are the m distinct elements. Now suppose conversely means we are supposing that it is containing any two elements that are equal, means we are saying that this is not m distinct element. So let any two elements are equal. That is to say, it implies AHi equals to AHj, which implies Hi equals to Hj. This is why left cancellation law. If this is equals to this, means h I equals to h j, it implies the order of h is not equals to n. If these two elements are equal, it means the order of the subgroup will not be equal to m. It means it should be less than n, and this is the contradiction of the supposition. Supposition was, we were supposing that it is containing a distinct element. So this is the contradiction. Therefore, we can say each coset consists m distinct elements. This is part one. Now the part two, consider the left coset decomposition of G related to H. So consider the left coset decomposition. So this was the first part, and this is the second part. Consider the left coset decomposition of G. Now, as we know, G, this is equals to A1H union A2H union A3H, A3H union and so on, AKH. G equals to A1H union A2H union A3H union and so on union AKH. This is K times. Now the order of G will be, this is order of A1H plus order of A2H plus order of A3H plus and so on order of AKH. This is K times. This is K times, and here it is to be noted here that AIH intersection AJH, this is equals to 5, means they are disjoint. This is important point. We should remember it. Now, the order of G is, this is given, this is n, and order of A1H, this is n, because each left coset contains n distinct element, so this will be n, this is also n, this is also n, and so on up to, this is also n, and this is k times. And n equals to, this implies n equals to k times m. This is k times m, or this is k equals to n upon m. This shows that the order of the subgroup is the divisor of the order of finite group, that is G. So therefore, and this is constant, because this is constant, therefore the order of H is a divisor of order of G. This is proved. So, what we have seen here, we have proved this theorem, and basically it is contained in two parts. This was the first part. At first we show that each quotient consists m distinct element, and then we have considered the left quotient decomposition. So this is proved. Thank you.